to the Colac Herald Sports Match for another week. Colac and District's highest rating online sports show, probably because it's the only online sports show.
We'll take that on a bet.
We certainly will. My name is Ben Martin. With me, as always, is Alex Baird with the netball, which we'll get into later. First of all, probably get stuck into the footy.
Yep, let's go for it, Benny.
Some big news for the Colac Tigers in the Geelong Football League. They've actually announced themselves as a genuine flag contender this year with a win against league powerhouse South Bowen, the reigning premiers. South Bowen probably not playing their best football, but any time you can beat the Swans, yep, is definitely a big confidence boost for your team, says coach Paul Lynch. Colac won this one 26-126 to 13-13-91. Jake McGuan, an absolute star at forward for the Tigers. He kicked 10 goals, wow, in the best on ground performance. Kane Smart kicked 3 for the Tigers, while other best players for them were Andrew Kelly, Dylan Fedley, Marcus Crook, Caden Newton, and the ruckman Levi Dare. For South Bowen, Reece Woods kicked 4 goals in a best on ground performance. We'll get stuck into the Colac District football now. A pretty big result for Forest here. Probably hadn't seen their best yet, but they've actually put their hand up as a genuine finals contender here with a win against the previously unbeaten Apollo Bay. Forest won this one 10-10-70 to 6-11-47. Danny Phillips and Brenton Flynn kicked 2 goals for the Lions, while their best players were Andrew White, Ryan Conley, and the ruckman Matthew Piggott, Michael Condon kicked 2 goals for Apollo Bay and was among the best players, with Justin Robbins and his brother Damien Condon. Yeah. In other football matches of the weekend now, Berrigarra defeated Lawn 12-9-81 to 5-5-35. Best players for the Saints was Josh Weatherhead. Best for the Dolphins was Ricky White. Colac Imperials 23-13-151 had a big win against Western Eagles 4-6-30. Jai Tillich best for the Imps, while James Beasley was the best for the Western Eagles. Simpson had a win against Ilroy Bec, a bit of a fiery one this one. Simpson won 10-9-69 to 3-12-30. Best players for the Tigers, Brenton Jeong. Matt Dunn was the best player for Ilroy Bec. And finally, LV 12-19-91 defeated Otway Districts 4-3-27. Lockie Marnie, the best player for the Swans. While the Demons' best was Ian Davo Davidson. So that wraps things up for round 4 of Colac District Football and Geelong Football. We'll cross it over to Alex with the netball.
Thanks, Benny. Yeah, I'll move into Geelong Football Netball League first. Colac Tigers officials say the scoreline didn't reflect its side's performance against Geelong powerhouse South Bowen. The Tigers did lose by 19 goals, but largely due to a lapse in the second quarter. But co-coach Stacey McCarthy said her team found form, especially through Shelley Scott, who played her best game for the season. Other best players included Maddie Allen, who's netted 21 goals, and Chelsea Hillman had a great game as well. A feature match this week in Colac and District Netball was a fiery clash between Simpson and Illawarra Beak. The Tigers got over the line by 1 goal, which was a fantastic effort. They trailed all day at each quarter time, half time, and three quarter time, but they managed to get over the line in the end. Simpson's best was Georgie Rook, and Illawarra Beak defender Beth O'Brien starred in defence, so that was a good effort from those two. It sets up a mouthwatering clash between the Tigers and reigning premier Colac Imps in round 5 next weekend. In other games, Lawn held off Berrigarra 36-29. The Dolphins' best included Caitlin Cross, while Ashley Williamson starred for the Saints. Otway Districts won by just 3 goals against Alvey, 32-29. Demons' best was Lydia Denny, and Swans player Georgia Robinson had a good day in goals. Colac Imperials had a commanding 26-goal win against the Western Eagles. Imps' best was coach Candy Robbins, while veteran Eagle Jenny Fish had a strong game for her side. Our final game this week, Apollo Bay proved too strong for Forest with an 81-6 win. Katie Monaghan was good for the Hawks in goals, while Estelle Ballard worked hard all day for the Lions. And Ben, that wraps up netball. Looking forward to getting into next week again.
Thank you, Alex. That wraps things up for us here at the Sports Mash. Make sure you grab Wednesday's Colac Herald to keep up to date with all the Colac and District sporting news. Thanks again for joining us, and we'll see you next time.